So hello sir, we are from Group One, and today we're going to do our presentation. Our group consists of four person, just me, myself, Badri, and then we have you, and then we have Harvin and also Fabi. So we're going to start with our project overview.
Let's come to the project introduction and concept. So first of all, artificial intelligence is a technology which enables a machine to simulate human behavior. So in this project, it's a game where we analyze and classify the item that user shows to webcam to identify the classes based on our library creating using teachable machines. So the concept is image recognition. So machine language can be used for a face detection in an image as well.
For this interactive game, we are using five different items that can easily be found within the house. The kids can try to find it inside the kitchen, maybe inside the bedroom, because these things are very common in a house, which are bottle, book, bowl, comb, and also a pencil case. With the help of teachable machine, we created a model that can identify and classify between these five items. The minimum number of sample for each class is 50, but to be honest, I don't think that 50 is already enough, because if you can see the data set you can found online, for each class at least they are using around few thousands of samples for each class.
I'm going to talk about hyperparameters. The advantages of changing hyperparameters is to manage the entire behavior of the model training. It will help increase the efficiency of the model and produce the optimal result. In this teachable machine, the hyperparameters such as epochs, batch size, and learning rate are allowed to tweak the value to obtain the optimal result.
So continuing from having presentation, I'm going to add a little bit more on the comparison between when the epoch value is equal to 50 and when the epoch value is equal to 100. As you can see, when I assign the epoch value become 50, we have a few classes that the accuracy is not equal to 1. Means that some of the samples are misidentified as another item. So of 8 samples of the book, one of them are misidentified as a pencil case. So we can refer also to the pencil case model. So as you can see, out of 10 samples, we have one item that is misidentified as a book. And when you refer to the accuracy and also the coefficient matrix of when the epoch value is equal to 100, you can see that the accuracy is already equal to 1. Therefore, there is no item that is misidentified. You can refer to the coefficient matrix. Everything except for the degree is equal to 0. Therefore, no items is misidentified.
Next, lesson learned. So in our lesson learned, we're able to learn the basic principle of image recognition with the help of the teachable machine P5 by JFS and ML5 by JS. Next is we're able to observe different accuracy levels and loss caused by tweaking the numbers of epochs, batch size, and learning rate at the advanced setting of the teachable machines. And lastly, we're able to learn on file exporting for teachable machines as library and utilizing the ML5 by JS in order to complete the code on P5 project S.
In conclusion, Teachable Machine, ML5, and also P5JS are very useful tools that can be used for beginners. So Teachable Machine, we can create our model, while P5JS, we can use code our system, and ML5 can be used as classifier. And secondly, we are able to produce our desired interactive game that interact with the user and can identify the five classes of items. And lastly, we are able to observe the accuracy level changes whenever that we change the batch size, learning rate, and also our epoch value. All in all, I think every one of us are having fun while completing this project one. So now we are going to do the demonstration of our interactive game. For the final part, we have the demonstration of our interactive game. The game started with a canvas of front page and key press function. When the S key is pressed, a delay of 2 seconds will start to ensure that the user is ready. As the time is up, the user needs to find the instructor object and show it to the camera. The sequence of items started with a bottle, then a bowl, a comb, a pencil case, and ended with finding a book. To make sure that the user brings in the correct item, the good chalk page will only appear if the level is equal to the current function and the confidence level must be more than or equal to 90%. If the program only depended on a correct level, then even when the user didn't bring in anything, the good chalk page might still be appear. This is most probably due to the samples in the dataset. As you can see, I'm using a white wall as background and most of the samples of each class are having it too. Therefore, it might be mistaken as the object.
as the picture is processed as one item and not separated between the item itself and also the background.